Before watching the video, don't forget to subscribe the channel and enable bell notification to never miss an update from us.
Hello friend, welcome to NTR. My name is Akash Shukla and today we are going to discuss some arithmetic questions for RRB PO and Clerk 2020. And those arithmetic questions will be from previous year question, guys. Then we are going to discuss basically RRB PO 2019 questions. We are done with the part 1 of arithmetic questions. So this video is gonna be the part 2 of arithmetic questions. If you didn't watch that video so far, so link in the description field, you can watch that video also. So let's start today's video and with the very first question, guys. So this is the first question on your screen, guys, and this question is from what? This question is from boats and steam, guys. From boats and steam. Let's see how we can solve this. If a boat travels 18 km more in downstream than in upstream in 3 hours, okay. If the speed of boat in still water is what? 20 km per hour. Okay, so we are given with the speed of boat is what? Let's denote it as SB is given as 20 km per hour, guys. Then we need to find the distance traveled by boat in downstream in 4 hours. So let's understand the concept. Basically, if this is a stream, guys, if this is a stream, okay, if this is a stream and this stream is flowing towards this direction, okay, towards this direction, okay, and this is a boat, and if boat is traveling towards this direction, then we'll say it's a downstream motion. So the boat will have a downstream speed, and if the boat is traveling towards this direction, then it is called, that means against the stream. So this will be called as upstream direction, upstream motion, and the boat will have upstream speed, okay. So this will have upstream, and in this condition it will have downstream, guys. So this is the concept of upstream and downstream. We are given with what? We are given with a distance, a difference of distances, basically. So we know that speed equals distance upon time, or distance equals speed multiplied by time, okay. If the speed, downstream speed is what? SD, and upstream speed is what? SU. Then this difference multiplied by 3, we are given with 18 km, okay. Because if a boat travels 18 km more in downstream, okay, so 18 km more in downstream, that means downstream distance is more than the upstream distance. So this is how you can find out, okay, guys. And we know that downstream speed is what? It is nothing but speed of boat plus speed of current. And upstream speed is what? It is nothing but speed of boat minus speed of current. Now we can put this value in this equation, basically. Let's say it's the equation first. So if we put these two values in equation first, we can find SB plus SC minus SB plus SC multiply by 3 equals 18. Okay, 3, 6 is 18. This will be cut, and here will be 2 SC equals what? 6. So SC will be 3 km per hour. That means now we have the speed of upstream, speed of stream and speed of boat. So we have two types of speed. Now we can find out the downstream speed as what? Speed of boat plus speed of current. So downstream speed will be speed of boat 20 plus 3. Okay, that means 23 km per hour. And we need to find the distance, basically. So distance is what? Speed multiplied by time, guys. Speed, that means 23. Downstream speed in 4 hour, basically. Okay, so distance traveled by boat in downstream in 4 hour. That means time we are given with 4. So 23 multiplied by 4 will be what? 92. So 92 km will be your right answer. B will be your right answer, guys. Okay. Let's move to the next question. And before moving to the next question, guys, I need to tell you that on today only, that means July 22, we are going to conduct live mock, basically. Okay. Live mock for RRB PO. So you can join this live mock. It is still running, guys. You can join this live mock, and if you are among the top 3 rankers, then you will also get some surprising prizes. And the question this live mock has is a very good question. You can attempt and you can share your score with your friend also. So this will be a all India live mock. So all India aspirant will take part in this. Okay, so let's move to the next question now. दिस इज द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इन स्किन गाइज, एंड दिस क्वेश्चन इज फ्रॉम पार्टनरशिप टॉपिक, अ वेरी मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक, ओके, अ वेरी मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक फ्रॉम विच एटलीस्ट वन क्वेश्चन इज आस्क्ड इन द एग्जाम. लेट्स सी हाउ वी कैन सॉल्व दिस. इफ ए इन्वेस्टेड, ओके, ए इन्वेस्टेड रुपीज 12,000, ओके, फॉर अ सर्टेन टाइम पीरियड, वी डू नॉट नो सो फार, एंड बी जॉइंड हिम आफ्टर 3 months, ओके, बी जॉइंड हिम आफ्टर 3 months विद द इन्वेस्टमेंट ऑफ 16,000 रुपीज एट सेम रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट. इफ ए लिव्स बिफोर 2 months ऑफ कंप्लीशन, ओके, ही हैज लेफ्ट द बिजनेस बिफोर टू कंप्लीशन ऑफ इट, देन वट विल बी द शेयर ऑफ बीज प्रॉफिट आफ्टर 1 year, ओके. सो द टोटल टाइम पीरियड फॉर द बिजनेस वॉज 1 year, दैट मीन्स ए इन्वेस्टेड फॉर 10 months, because 1 year equal to what, 12 months, okay, and A has left the business before 2 months, so A was there in the business for 10 months and B was there in the business for 9 months, okay, because he has joined the business after 3 months. And now what is our next task in this type of question? We need to find the ratio of the A and B, okay, of their investment with respect to the time period. So 3 4 3 are 12, 4 4 are 16. This is how we can find the ratio. 3 3 are 9, guys. 2 2 are 4 and 2 5 are 10. That means 5:6 is what the ratio of investment of A and B with respect to their time periods. Then what will be the share of B's profit after 1 year if the total profit is what, 22,000. Now we are given with the total profit. See, guys, if the ratio of the investment of A and B, then investment ratio or investment, total investment is directly proportional to what, total profit, okay. So A and B, that means 5 plus 6 will be equal to what, 22,000. 11 will be equal to 22,000, guys. Then 1 will be equal to 2,000. And in the question, it is asked that we need to find the share of B's profit. So what will be the share of B's profit? That is 6. Then we need to find the value of 6. So 6 will be 6 multiplied by 2,000. It means 12,000 will be your right answer. So C will be your right answer. Let's move to the next question. This is the next question, skin guys. And this question is from pipe and cistern. Okay, pipe and cistern. Let's see how we can solve this. If pipes A and B, okay, so there are two pipes we have given with so far. A can fill a tank in 15 minutes, okay, and B can fill it in 20 minutes, okay, and pipe C, okay, pipe C is also there in the story. Pipe C can empty the tank in 12 minutes, okay. So see, the what is the difference between the A and B and C pipe? Basically, both A and B are the filling pipe, whereas pipe C is what? Pipe C is emptying pipe. That means it can only empty the cistern rather than filling it. Okay. So what is the next task? Our next task is we need to take the LCM of these three. Okay. What is the LCM of these three? It is nothing but it is the least number that can be completely divisible by these three individually. Okay. So only 60 is there. So 60 is what? 60 will be the capacity of the cistern, guys. 60 is what? Capacity of cistern. If 60 is the capacity of cistern, now we can find the individual efficiency of A, B and C. Efficiency is nothing but filling, this how much unit A can fill per minute. This will be called as the efficiency of A. So 60 divided by 15 is what, 4. 60 divided by 20 is what, 3. And 60 divided by 12 is what, 5. So these are the respective efficiency of A, B and C. Okay. What will be the time taken by A, B and C together to fill the tank completely? So one thing you need to note, guys, these will be plus plus and these will be minus because it is an emptying tank. So plus plus and minus. So let's see first whether the tank will be empty or whether the tank will be filled. So 4 plus 3, okay, and this is minus 5. So 4 plus 3 is what, 7, minus 5 is what, 2. 2 is what, it is positive. Because it is positive, so tank will be filled definitely. Okay, tank will be filled. And how, in how many times? So time is what? Total capacity 60 divided by 4 plus 3 minus 5. Same as in the work and time concept. So 60 divided by 4 plus 3 minus 5 is what? 2. That means 30 minutes. Okay. So guys, 30 minutes will be the time when A, B and C together will be open and they will take to fill the tank. Let's move to the next question now. गाइज दिस क्वेश्चन इज फ्रॉम प्रॉफिट लॉस एंड डिस्काउंट. ओके, प्रॉफिट लॉस एंड डिस्काउंट अ वेरी मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक फॉर RRB PU एंड कलर बिकॉज 2 to 3 एंड समटाइम 3 to 4 क्वेश्चन आर आज फ्रॉम दिस टॉपिक ओनली. ओके, सो लेट्स सी हाउ वी कैन सॉल्व दी. इफ अ शॉपकीपर मार्क्स एन आइटम 100% अबाउ इट्स कॉस्ट प्राइस, सो फॉर से इफ द कॉस्ट प्राइस ऑफ दैट आइटम इज 100, देन द मार्क प्राइस विल बी 50% ऑफ अबाउ दिस, दैट मीन्स 150% ऑफ दिस, सो दैट मीन्स 150. ओके, एंड इफ 12% डिस्काउंट इज गिवन ऑन द मार्क प्राइस, ओके, सो माइनस 12% ऑफ दिस विल बी वॉट सेलिंग प्राइस. ओके, बेसिकली आफ्टर गिविंग द डिस्काउंट ऑन मार्क प्राइस वट एवर द प्राइस विल बी ऑब्टेन दिस विल बी कॉल्ड एज सेलिंग प्राइस. ओके, सो 150 माइनस 12% ऑफ 150 वट विल बी देयर गाइज, तो 12% ऑफ दिस वॉट, 12% ऑफ दिस विल बी माइनस 12%, दैट मीन्स 12% ऑफ दिस विल बी 18, सो माइनस 18 विल बी डूइंग. ओके, सो 132 विल बी द सेलिंग प्राइस. नाउ वी हैव कॉस्ट प्राइस, मार्क प्राइस, सेलिंग प्राइस. ओके, कॉस्ट प्राइस, मार्क प्राइस एंड सेलिंग प्राइस. सो इन द क्वेश्चन इज गिवन है एंड द शॉपकीपर मेक्स अ प्रॉफिट ऑफ 256 रुपीज. प्रॉफिट इज व्हाट गाइस? प्रॉफिट इज नथिंग बट इट्स अ सेलिंग प्राइस माइनस कॉस्ट प्राइस. ओके, सेलिंग प्राइस इन द क्वेश्चन वी आर गिवन विद 132 एंड हियर इज 100. ओके, एज आर अजम्पशन. ओके, सो दिस विल बी व्हाट, 32. सो दिस 32 यूनिट इज गिवन एज 256 इन द क्वेश्चन. सो वन विल बी व्हाट, ऑब्वियसली 8. One unit will be representing as 8. Then what will be the actual cost price? So we need to find the 100 unit. So the value of 100 unit will be what? 100 multiplied by 8. That means 800 will be your right answer, guys. B will be your right answer. Okay. Let's move to the next question now. This is the next question skin, guys. And this question from SI and CI. So just make sure. I will tell you one thing, guys, and this is very true because in the today's scenario, the mixed concept of SI and CI is in trend. Okay, so the question based on the mixed concept of SI and CI is asked in the examination. So let's practice more and more these questions. So if a person invested 6,000 rupees, okay, 6,000 rupees with T percent rate of interest for 3 years, okay, so SI will be this. SI will be this amount, and same amount at T plus 5% for CI for 2 years. Okay, so CI for T plus 5%. Okay, at T plus 5% for how many years? 2 years, guys. Okay, and now we are given with the difference between SI and CI. Okay, so difference we are given with between SI and CI. So SI and CI we are given with the difference as 60 rupees. 60 rupees. Okay, so these are the quantities or these are the information we are given with in questions. So how we can solve this, guys? Let's say we will be opting hit and trial approach here. Hit and trial approach. So let's pick the first option first, 15. So if SI equals 6000 multiplied by T is what? T is what? 15 multiplied by 3 divided by 100. That means this will be cancelled out. 15, 3 are 45, 6 are 270. So 2700 will be the SI here, and CI will be what? CI will be CI, and this T plus 5 will be what? 20%, because T, we have taken T as 15 from the option, and CI will be what? 6000 multiply by what? You know, guys. CI, compound interest, is nothing but interest on interest. That means 20, this interest 20 plus 20 multiplied by 20 multiplied by 20. That means successive interest, guys. So 44 will be there. So we need to find the 44% of 6000. Okay. So this will be cancelling out and this will be equal to what? 2640. And now find the difference between this SI and this CI. Okay. So 2700 minus 2640, it is what? It is rupees 60. Yeah, it is rupees 60. That means our assumption is correct. T will be what? T will be 15. So this is called the hit and trial approach, guys. So T will be 15 here. Okay, 15%. Now let's move to the next question. This was a very good question. This question again is from what? Partnership, guys. Okay, partnership. Basically, it's a combination of partnership and ratio and proportion. Okay, partnership. So let's see how we can solve this. If P invested 60% more than Q, okay, R invested 20% more than Q, that means the investment of P and R both depend on the investment of Q. So P, Q and R, if the investment of Q is 100, then the investment of P will be 60% more than this, and the investment of R will be 20% more than this. Okay, so this will be the investment, guys, and the ratio of investment of the time period, okay, and the time period will be what? This will be the investment ratio, okay, investment, and time period we are given with time period 2:4:3 for PQR. That means now we can find the ratio PQR as 160 multiplied by 2, 100 multiplied by 4, and 120 multiplied by 3. Because profit distribution is nothing, it is the investment multiplied by time period. For example, P invested 160 rupees, but for how much period of time? This is for 2 years, say, okay. And same as Q invested 100 rupees for, say, 4 years. So the investment, so the profit distribution for Q will be 100 multiplied by 4, and the profit distribution for P will be 160 multiplied by 2. So now let's find these ratio. Okay, so this will be what? 320. This will be what? 400. This will be what? 360. So this ratio will be 32:40:36. That means 4 9 ja 36 and 4 10 ja and 4 8 ja. That means the ratio of P, Q and R of their ratio of the investment with respect to time period will be what? 8:10:9. Okay, that means, and now we are given with what? The sum of the profit share of Q and R is what? 8550 of Q and R. Of Q and R, that means 10 plus 9 we are given with 8550. So 19 will be 8550. So 1 will be what? It will be 8550 divided by 19. That means 19 4s are 76 and 19 5s, yeah. So 1 unit will be representing what? 450. And we need to find what? We need to find the profit share of P. That means we need to find the value of 8. So 8 multiplied by 450 will be what? 45 2s are 90, 90 2s are 180, and 180 2s are 360. Okay, so 360, and this is how you can multiply, guys. So 3600 will be your right answer. D will be your right answer. Now let's move to the next question. This question is again from profit and loss, guys. Okay, again from profit and loss, and from RRB PO 2019. Okay, let's see how we can solve this. A person sold an article, his profit percent is what? 60%. Okay, his profit percent is 60%. So for say, if the selling price is what? 100, and profit will be what? 60. Profit percent is 60% of the selling price. Okay, so selling price is 100, then profit will be 60, and the CP will be what? CP will be 100 minus 60, because it is nothing but SP minus profit. So 40 will be the SCP. So 40 CP, SP is worth 100 and profit is worth 60. If the cost price is increased by 75%, okay, cost price is 40 now, and if we increase this by 75%, then how we can do that? What will be the 75% of 40, guys? 75% of 40 is nothing but 3/4 of 40. That means 30. Okay, so if CP initially was 40, then finally it will be 40 plus 30, that means 70, obviously, and the selling price remains same. Okay, CP is there, it is, this is, and selling price is what? 100, because it is remain same as in the previous value. Then find the decrement in the profit. So how much decrement in the profit will be? Profit will be what? Selling price minus cost price for this case, guys. Okay, so 30. So how much decrement in the profit? It is what? It is nothing but 30. How, and in the question it is asked, they then find the decrement in the profit is what percent of the selling price. Basically, it is what percent of selling price? Selling price is nothing but 100 multiplied by 100. This is what? This is the required percentage. Okay, required percentage, guys. So required percentage will be what? 30%. So 30% will be your right answer for this question. B will be your right answer. Let's move to the next question. This is the next question on screen, guys, and this question is from where? This question is from mensuration. Okay, let's see how we can solve this. Area of first circle and circumference of second circle we are given with. Okay, so area is what? 1386. And we know the area of circle is what? It is pi r square. That means we are given with the value of pi r square as 1386. Let's say the ratio, the radius of the first circle is r1. Okay, that means r1 square is what? 1386 multiplied by 7 divided by 22. Divided by 22. So 11 to the 22 and 11. 11 to the 22 and 11 6 ja, yeah, 11 1 ja 11 and 11 to 2 ja 22 and 11 6 ja, okay, so 126, and that means 2 6 ja 12, 2 3 ja 6, so 63 multiply by 7 is what? 7 multiply by 9 multiply by 7. Okay, so R1 will be what? 7 multiply by 3, that means 21 centimeter is the R1. And R2 will be what? And now we are given with the circumference. We know the circumference is what? 2 pi r is 176 centimeter. We are given with, that means 2 multiplied by 20 divided by 7 multiplied by R2 equals 176. Let's say the radius of second circle is R2, guys. Okay. Now we can find the value of R2. Okay, we can find the value of R2 as R2 equals 176 multiplied by 7 divided by 2 multiplied by 22. So this will be what? 44, sorry. So 44 fours are 176, that means 28 will be the R2. There is a square. Okay, now square is also there in the story, whose side is what? 35:5/7%. So 35:5/7% is what? It is nothing but 5/14. Okay, so the value of this is what? 5/14, guys. So is 5/14 of twice of the sum of the radius of both the circles. So first of all, find the sum. Okay, the sum is what? 21 plus 28, that means 49 centimeter, and twice of this multiply by 5/14 of this also. Okay, so 2 7 is 14 and 7 7 is 49, that means 35 centimeter is the side of the square. Okay, now we have the side of the square and we need to find the perimeter of the square. So perimeter of square is what? Perimeter is nothing but 4 multiply by side for the square. Okay, so 4 multiply by side, that means 4 multiply by 35 2 is 70, 72 is 140. So 140 centimeter will be your right answer. C will be your right answer. Let's move to the next question without wasting any time. This is the next question, and this question is again from profit and loss. I told you, because profit, loss and discount is a very most important topic from where 2 to 3 and sometimes 3 to 4 questions are asked. Okay, so let's see how we can solve this. An article is marked 66:2/3%. So this, what the value of this will be? What? 2/3, guys. 2/3. 2/3 above the cost price. Okay, above the cost price. That means if cost price is 3x, then the mark price will be what? Mark price will be 3x plus 2x, that means 5x. Okay, 5x will be the mark price. And again, in the question is given that, and the loss incurred on selling that article is 25% of the discount. Okay, we know the value of the 25%. The value of 25% is what? 1/4. That means if discount is 4, let's say it's 4y, then what will be the loss? The loss will be 25% of this. That means y, obviously we have the discount. Okay, we have the loss. So what we can find? And we have the cost price also. So selling price will be what? Selling price will be what? Selling price, it is nothing but in case of loss, the selling price, loss will be what? If there is a loss incurred on selling a particular article, guys. So loss will be what? Cost price minus selling price, because in this case, cost price is greater than the selling price. Okay, I am telling you from the very basic, guys. So selling price will be what? Cost price minus loss. So cost price what? 3x minus y. So this will be what? Selling price. And in this case, selling price will be what? After giving some discount on mark price, what the price we get now? This is called the selling price. So 5x minus 4y will be what? This will be the selling price. So this is the selling price. This is the selling price. And we have the transaction of a single article, only a single article. Okay, so we can make the selling price equal. So 3x minus y equals 5x minus 4y. Okay, from these two equation, guys. Okay, don't get confused. So this will be what, 2x, and this will be what, 3y. That means we can find the value of what? We can find the value of x as 3y by 2. That means mark price will be what? 5 multiplied by 3y by 2, that means 15y by 2. Okay, we have the mark price, guys. And we need to find the discount percent. So discount percent is what? 4y. So discount percent is 4y, and it is always counted on mark price, guys. Mark price what? 15y by 2 multiplied by 100. This will be what? This will be discount percent, obviously. That means 4 to the 8 divided by 15 multiplied by 100. And 5 3 is 15, and 5 20, that means 160 by 3, or 53:1/3% will be your right answer, guys. Okay, will be your right answer. 53:1/3%. So B will be your right answer. Let's move to the next question now. This is the next question, and this question from speed, time and distance, and in that segment this question is from train based problem. Okay, train based problem. So let's see how we can solve this. A train traveling at 72 km/h. Okay, 72 km/h. And you also know that if the speed is given in 72 km/h, then we need to convert it into meter per second. So how we can convert it? By multiplying this by 5/18. Okay, and this will be equal to, guys, this is basically crosses. Okay, crosses. So a train traveling at 72 km/h crosses a platform, because train is crossing a platform that have some length, okay, of 160 meter. Okay, so the platform has length of 160 meter in 18 second. Okay, and another train traveling at 90 km/h. Okay, 160 meter is the length of the platform, and we don't have the length of the train first. So LT1 plus 160/18, this will be your equation first. And another train traveling at 90 km/h. Okay, another train traveling at 90 km/h. So we need to convert this again in meter per second, equals length of train T2 plus, because it is crossing the same platform, then we need to take the length of that platform, that is 160/15. Okay, 18, 5 is a 90, and 5 5 is a 25 multiplied by 15 minus 160 will be what? Length of train T2, that means length of second train. So 25, this will be what? 375 minus 160 equals LT2. So we can find the value of LT2 as 5, 7 minus 6, 1 and 2. 215 will be your, because the length of the another train we need to find, that means 215 will be your right answer. So guys, you've seen one thing, that this line in the question given, okay, this line in the question, this line is usual. There is no means of this line, except we have the length of platform from there. Okay, so in the question, examiner has given this line just to get confused the students. Okay, so don't get worried, just keep and calm and stay motivated by solving the question. Stay focused, basically. Okay, so you need to stay focused by solving the question, and then start solving the question, and you can get answer correctly, guys. Okay, so this is all about the video. And one more thing I need to tell you before completing this video. It is July 22, guys, and we are conducting live mock today. We are conducting live mock for RRB PO level. Okay, RRB PO level, and the timing will be from 10 a.m. to 12 a.m. midnight. Okay, so you have lot of time to attempt this question paper. And there's also surprising thing for you, top three winners according to the rank board, guys. Rank board will also get public, where you can check your performance, where you can check your rank among all India aspirant, because this is nothing but all India live mock, guys. All India live mock, and entry is conducting for you, guys. So top three ranker according to the rank board, top three ranker will get surprising prizes, guys. Okay, surprising prizes. We have given the surprising prizes for RRB clerk level live mock. Okay, if you don't know, so I am telling you, RRB clerk mock, we have for that mock we have chosen three candidate who have performed better in that case, okay, and they got top 3 ranks among the all India live mock aspirants. So please go and download the entry app and see the info and attempt All India Live Mock. The same link you can find in the description field. Attempt this All India Live Mock and see what's your performance among the All India aspirant. So this is all about the video, guys. And again, one more thing I need to tell you, we have also started IBPS RRB rank booster, guys. Okay. RRB rank booster quiz, attempt free. This is a free of cost. Obviously the live mock I just told you this is also a free of cost for all students, for all India students. It's a free of cost, guys. And this rank booster quiz that daily starts at 10 a.m. and 15 question 15 minutes we are providing you in alternate manner. That means for first we are providing you quant and second we are providing you for the reasoning. So this alternate manner we are following you on a daily basis. We are giving you the quiz and free of cost, so you can attempt these free daily quiz also. So in that case, that means we are giving you free content, okay, free content for free of cost. Lots of contents will be there, so go and download the app and see what the content is there. So please like the video, guys. Comment whatever the thing in your mind, comment down in the comment box and please let me know. I will definitely reply and please share the video. And if you are new to this channel, then please subscribe also, okay. So I will complete this video with this thing. This is Akash Shukla signing off, and good luck for exam, guys.